Okay, so here we have a triangle that we're trying to solve, and we're going to round our answers to the nearest tenth. So we're going to have alpha, beta, gamma, and A, B, C. So angles, alpha, beta, gamma, sides, A, B, C. And we don't know A, but we know this is B over here, this is gamma, and this is C over there. So we know C is 12, and we know B is 9. And we know gamma is 85 degrees. Okay, looking at what we know, we're going to use then sine beta over B equals sine gamma over C. And then plugging in what we know, sine beta over 9 equals sine 85 degrees over, I think it's 85, yeah, 12. And then we're going to say sine beta equals 9 times sine 85 over 12. And then we have to do an inverse sine to find beta. So inverse sine of 9 sine 85. And I'm putting those parentheses in to remind me to close off that parenthesis. Okay, so when I do this, let's see, inverse sine 9 sine 85 divided by 12, and I get beta is approximately equal to 48.3 degrees. Now, does that seem reasonable according to our drawing? So right here, we just found beta. That's an acute angle, less than 90 degrees, and 48.3 is less than 90 degrees. But what if there was another possibility? So this drawing's going to look a little weird, but you have to pretend like maybe the triangle was really close to having a second possibility. So what I would have to do is I would have to consider the side I don't know extended, you know, infinitely, and then the 12 swinging out to be, you know, another side of a triangle. So I have two triangles. I have the smaller triangle in black, and then this larger one working in orange. Okay, so how do you find this side, this angle right here? Well, that angle's going to be, let's see, and remember this has to be 12 here. Okay, that angle's going to be the supplement of 48.3, so 180 minus 48.3, which winds up being, let's see, 131.7 degrees. Okay, if that's 137, then this also has to be 137, because you have to pretend like this is an isosceles triangle, right? Because they're both sides are 12 there. And so now I have an angle of 131.7 degrees plus this 85 degrees plus whatever alpha is, okay? So if I take 180 and I subtract 85, that's this angle here, and I subtract 131.7, that's going to be a problem. I'm going to get that to be alpha, and it's going to be a negative number. See, it's too big. I have too much angle going on. So there's not going to be a second case. There's only going to be the little triangle here. Okay? So you can't always tell just by looking. That one seemed kind of obvious because we could see, oh, that doesn't look right. But you might have one where it didn't look that obvious, and so how do you figure it out? Well, if you get an angle and the three angles, or the two angles, I should say, that you have add up to be more than 180, then you can't have that because you've got to have a third angle, okay? So this isn't going to work. Okay, so now we know gamma is 85. We know beta is approximately 48.3 degrees. And now we can find alpha by taking the 180 and subtracting the 48.3 and the 85. And what does that give us? 180 minus 48.3 minus 85, 46.7. Could add those up and make sure. Yeah, that looks right. I think. What else do we want to do? Oh, okay. Well, we've found everything, but we've got to find A, side A. And it will be an approximation. We ruled out there being two cases. So we know that this is going to be our only option here. So I'm going to have to use A over sine alpha equals, and then I would go with gamma. So those were the ones that we knew. C over sine gamma. Oops. Gamma. That's supposed to be a gamma. Alright. And then we can plug in those values. Let me scroll this up a little bit. And alpha was, oh great, I lost alpha. It was 46.7, I think. Yeah. Oops, 7. And that's equaling C, which was 12, over sine 85. So A is going to equal 12 sine 46.7 divided by sine 85. And I'll stop so I can... I'm getting A to be approximately 8.8. So I'll put that in my chart here. You might say, why does she always do this on her calculator? You know, she could just look and see. But I always want to make sure that I have the numbers written right, because that would be really confusing to you if I didn't. Okay.